Hi everybody, I'm Tammy and welcome to Every Day in the Sacred. I was just wondering, if you could choose somebody to pray for you and to intercede on your behalf, who would you choose? You know, oftentimes the prayer partners that we want are people we know have a good relationship with God, people we know are solid in the Word, people we know would be able to stand in the gap for us. What that does, it also gives us confidence to know that we're not only approaching the throne of the Lord on our own, but we come with others. And you know, when two or more are gathered in my name, says the Lord, there am I too. So we may not even be gathered physically together, but you know that you're gathered in spirit, in same intentions, same vision, same plea as you go before the Lord. But I came across a verse, an entire chapter, that speaks of an intercessor for all ages, an intercessor of intercessors. And let me tell you who that is. Let's go to the book of John, John 17. Now, this is where Jesus is going towards the crucifixion. It's towards the end of his physical earthly life. And what he does is he, first of all, prays for himself. He then prays for his disciples, the people that he has walked with, that he has taught and instructed, and he prays for their strength and for God to protect them. And then, I love this part, he prays for you and he prays for me. Yes, he does. So it's John 17 verse 20. Here's what Jesus prayed for towards his end. He says, my prayer is not for them alone. Meaning my prayer is not just for my disciples, the ones who know me and whom I know. I also pray for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one. Father, just as you are in me and I am in you, may they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave to me, that they may be one as we are one. I in them and you in me. May they be brought to complete unity, to let the world know that you sent me and have loved them even as you loved me. Father, I want those that you have given me to be with me where I am and to see my glory, the glory that you have given me because you loved me before the creation of the world. Righteous Father, though the world does not know you, I know you, and they know that you have sent me. I have made you known to them and will continue to make you known in order that the love that you have for me may be in them, and that I myself may be in them. I don't know about you, but this is all the prayer that I need. A prayer from over 2,000 years ago. The word that was made flesh. He who said, I will go. For reunion, of relationship, for salvation. He prayed for you, even before you were born. He prayed for you knowing that you would believe in him, knowing that you would have your challenges, knowing that the church would be fragmented. And here we see where the heart of Christ is. Because he says, may they be brought to complete unity, to let the world know that you sent me. So Christ prayed for our union as the body of Christ. Christ prayed that we may know him, that he may be in us, and that we may be in him. And knowing that God had you on his mind all along, that should give you the biggest peace that you'll ever need. Knowing that you've been predestined, knowing that you will be with him. Because he says, Father, let them be where I am. So this is not just left to the roll of the dice. No. God has a specific plan for you, and he knew you even before you came to be. The biggest intercessor, the greatest intercessor, the only intercessor that we truly, truly need. So may we go out into the world knowing that God has got our backs, knowing that Christ not only prayed for himself and those that he lived with at that particular time, but he prayed for all those who would believe because of the work of the disciples. I don't know about you, but that gives me incredible peace. May the peace of the Lord be with you.